PepsiCo Philippines works with global startup Plastic Credit Exchange and the local government of Pasig to launch a waste-to-cash program for female micro-entrepreneurs in the city. For more on this, we are joined by Nitin Bandari. He's PepsiCo's general manager here in the Philippines. Nitin, good morning and welcome to the program.
Hi, Rain. Good morning.
You've been busy. It's a Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Yeah. You've been busy since the pandemic. It seems to have become an opportunity for you, actually, to transform and transition, introducing PEP Positive or PepsiCo Positive from one end of your operations to the other. Can you share with us what this initiative involves?
Yes, absolutely. Rin, before I talk through the entire initiative, you know, I'd just like to give some context. And if you pause for a minute and think about where do all your food and beverages come from? Right? How are these ingredients grown? How are they made? How are they packaged, shipped, and then sold before they arrive in your house? Right? And all the choices that you make today, how they impact the planet and how they impact the family. So you will realize that we operate in a very complex global food system. It's an elaborate network of individual farmers, manufacturers, distributors, retailers, right? Now, this huge global food system, while it provides a lot of nourishment for billions of people, but it also creates billions of tons of greenhouse gases. You know, it creates massive amount of waste, and that is not sustainable. At PepsiCo, we know that a better food system means better outcomes for our people and the planet. And we also know that PepsiCo is a very important player within this global food system. You know, with our huge scale that we have, you know, we believe it's a huge opportunity and also a responsibility for us to do our part, right? And to make a massive positive impact on the planet and the people. So recently we've announced one of our most ambitious efforts, you know, by embracing a bold new approach. We call this PepsiCo Positive. PepsiCo Positive is not one more social responsibility initiative. It really is the future of our company. We are seeing it as an end-to-end strategic transformation of what we do and also how we do it, with sustainability at the center of how we create value for our shareholders and all the other stakeholders. You know, all the work that we will do in this, you know, is going to, you know, form under three big pillars. It's a comprehensive framework with science-based targets. The three big pillars are, first is positive agriculture. You know, PepsiCo has a large agricultural footprint, and you'll be surprised to know that we have around 7 million acres of agricultural, land that we work across 60 countries. Now, we are working towards, you know, spreading regenerative practices to restore the earth across all the footprint of 7 million acres that we operate, to source our crops more sustainably and impact the agricultural supply chain in a very positive way. So how we produce. The second is positive value chain. You know, this is, we are trying to create and partner to create a circular and inclusive value chain. We've taken really audacious targets, right? We recently announced it as well. You know, we want to achieve net zero emissions by 2040, net zero. We want to become water positive by 2030. And one of the key things that we are talking about in this entire value chain is how do we introduce more sustainable packaging into our value chain? We know plastics is an issue and a challenge, and you know, it will require a lot of innovation, a lot of effort across the ecosystem to do that. So all of that work sits under positive value chain. And the last one is positive choices. We offer a wide range of portfolio, both across foods and beverages. And consumers, they love our products. You know, our vision is to, you know, delight them with every sip and every bite. But with PEP Positive, we want to do it in a way that we're encouraging positive choices, right? How do we reduce added sugar? How do we reduce sodium? How do we ensure more and more of our products are cooked in healthier oils, right? Mm. Besides potato and corn, like the chips and burritos that you eat, how do we get more healthier ingredients like chickpeas, plant-based proteins into our portfolio? So how we are seeing this piece is really an end-to-end transformation about how we grow things, how we manufacture and sell things, and the portfolio that we build for the future. This is really going to define the future of PepsiCo, and we are all really committed and excited about it.
Nitin, and this is a really important discussion and really an example to be set across multiple businesses, different segments, positive agriculture, positive value chains, positive choices. What spurred this movement? Did pressure from governments to have more environmentally sound processes and outputs contribute to this? Or does it really contribute more to the bottom line? And if it does, have you seen how much it does, perhaps in the region or in the Philippines?
Great question. You know, PepsiCo, at PepsiCo, our long-term vision is to add and create value for our shareholders and all our stakeholders, right? You know, we have to accelerate growth. You know, we've done that really well in the last 3-4 years. I'm sure you were tracking our quarterly releases. Mm-hmm. Despite the pandemic, we've done quite well. Despite all the challenges that the pandemic has brought in. You know, this got us thinking that we've done well for the last 3 to 4 years, but we want to do really well over the next 10, 20, 30, 40 years as well, right? So the question to ask is, you know, not what do we need to do to grow really well in the next 3 to 5 years, but how do we need to transform ourselves to deliver this long-term growth and long-term profit over many, many years to come? Right. And it's really clear now that there is a direct link that needs to be established between our business decisions and how it impacts the planet and the overall ecosystem. The PEP positive agenda is not an agenda, you know, which has been forced upon us. You know, we believe this is the right thing to do to grow sustainably. And this is going to help build significant advantages into our business. You know, I'll give you a couple of examples. Maybe you know it can clarify a little bit. You know, we know the fact that, you know, businesses and brands that will be more conscious of sustainability, there's a lot of traction from the consumers for those brands. Customers also want to partner with those brands. So we believe that this initiative is going to drive preference from consumers for our brands. This is going to help us drive stronger partnerships with our customers, the retailers.
But also, it's just that we do have 3 more questions to go through. So basically, the bottom line, have you seen it actually grow? Is there a number to how this initiative has actually contributed to your income revenues?
You know, what I'm trying to say is that, you know, this is the initiative that we've launched like in September, October of last year. And this is a long-term 10, 20, 30-year initiative. We believe as the consumers and customers, you know, we gain better preferences and as we attract better talent because of it. Because a lot of the people want to work for companies that are more environmentally conscious. It's no rocket science. If you have better talent, if you have better customer preference, if you have better consumer preference, you are going to do better. So, you know, this is not charity. This is central to how we see the business is going to be done.
Definitely a big PepsiCo investment in ESG. It also reaches the grassroots here in the Philippines with the Plastic Credit Exchange, a global nonprofit plastic offset program. How does it benefit the consumers as much as the communities where PepsiCo is present, starting with Pasig City?
Oh, yes, absolutely. Thanks for the question. You know, for Philippines, we know that plastic waste has been a major concern over the last few years, right? So we took this ambitious decision to become 100% plastic neutral for our foods business in the Philippines. And what does 100% plastic neutral mean? It means that PepsiCo collects as much plastic waste back from the environment as we put into the environment. And, you know, this was a very challenging task to create a circular economy, and collection of plastic waste was a huge, huge task. We partnered with Plastic Credit Exchange, and you know, we are really, really happy with what we've achieved. You know, we've been able to collect back 900,000 kilos of plastic waste in 2020 alone. And Philippines has become the first country globally within PepsiCo to become 100% plastic neutral. We all are really, really proud of this achievement, right? So one, you know, this is the right thing to do, and you know, we've done really well in 2020. Mm-hmm. You know, how it, you know, impacts the communities and the consumers, you know, I just like to share, you know, how the whole thing operates. Plastic Credit Exchange and PepsiCo partnered, and we started this Aling Tindera program, which is a waste to cash program in Metro Manila in 2020. And with the help of, you know, women micro entrepreneurs, right, you know, we've been able to create an inclusive circular economy. You know, what happens is by joining the network of Aling Tindera members, women are establishing their stores as a community collection point for plastics. So local waste collectors, junk shop owners, community members can come and sell their clean plastic waste for cash. So not only is this helping to clean the environment by collecting plastic waste, this is also adding back significant money back into the community. So it's a win-win for the overall ecosystem, we feel. And, you know, we feel more and more sustainability conscious businesses like PepsiCo should, you know, be coming on board and supporting to finance the plastic buyback. You know, via the plastic credit offsets, you know, that we are doing with Plastic Credit Exchange.
Is there an estimate as to how much this has actually contributed to the communities already? We know you're present in hundreds more locations across the Philippines.
Oh, I know. This is obviously, we started small in Metro Manila, but, you know, the program has been scaled up. We recently scaled it up in Pasig City, and we launched it with Mayor Vico Soto in December 2021. In 2022, we expect this to be across 76 locations. It's the 76th year of PepsiCo in Philippines, so across 76 locations, we'll get there. No, this is gonna be a big, big program, and you know, we see that, you know, this is only gonna go from strength to strength, and we're gonna be scaling up in the future as well.
Right, Nitin, you're head for beverages and foods for the Philippines, but also for foods for Malaysia, Singapore, and Indonesia. All these efforts, do they change the products themselves? Have you seen a need to evolve them as well to the changing tastes and sensitivities of the different markets?
Yes, you know, at PepsiCo, we believe, you know, that we need to be consumer-centric, right, to be able to become a faster, stronger, and better company. We think global, but we act really local. So therefore, there's a lot of work that happens to understand the consumer needs in each of the countries that we operate in. And we build in the portfolio and innovation that best fits the need of the consumers. We've always done that. I think with PEP Positive, our effort is now, how do we drive more positive choices within the portfolio? I'll possibly summarize it with an example to bring it to life. That how can PepsiCo Positive come to life in the future? And Lay's is a great example, right? Lay's is the world's largest food brand. We want to continue selling Lay's with the best potato chips in the market in a way that we keep up the promise with the customers. It needs to be great tasting. It needs to be lowest sodium levels in the market. The chips that you love need to be grown in potato farms which have regenerative fields. Then it needs to be made and delivered to you in a net zero supply chain and net water positive supply chain and sold to you in beautiful biocompostable bags. Now that's a positive choice. And now that's a significant transformation, you know, and that's the number one potato chip for the future.
Right.
I think that's how we're thinking about the portfolio, not just add new products, but transform our current portfolio as well.
And for every year of these initiatives, PepsiCo Positive and Plastic Credit Exchange, what is the measurable goal for the environment, for the company, and for the consumer? Do you plan to stop there? As COP27 showed, it seems to never really be enough.
You're right. You know, this is just start of the journey, right? You know, in 2020, as I mentioned to you, that 919,000 kilos of plastics was taken back. We became 100% plastic neutral. This is a great example of extended producer responsibility. We did this now, and we are committed to doing this year on year in the future as well as we grow. We already have global targets of PEP positive. I mentioned to you, right? Science-based targets that we have, net emissions to be zero by 2040. You know, the good part about these science-based targets is that, you know, they help to quantify the impact of our actions and cascade all the targets across the organization. So I know what I need to do over the next 5 years, 10 years. Now, obviously, I can tell you that this is a multi-year journey and we are fully committed to it. And this is just the start. In the end, I will just say one thing that, you know, we've taken up as PepsiCo a very bold and very ambitious target with PepsiCo Positive, but we believe that it's going to take all of us, right, to build a more sustainable future we need, to create value and stay within the planetary boundaries. So I hope that more and more companies come forward and support this piece, because it's not going to be PepsiCo alone, it's going to be all of us that will make the difference.
Well, cheers to the Philippines, cheers to PepsiCo for those efforts. Nitin Bhandari of PepsiCo Philippines, Indonesia, Malaysia, and Singapore, a pleasure to catch up with you today. We hope to speak with you again soon. Thank you so much for joining us.
Pleasure to be on your show.
We appreciate it.